Everyone, it's Eugene and here for another video. Today, what we're going to be doing is checking point cloud data and looking to see how flat it might be, or you're going to be checking an object to a plane and looking to see how it deviates from that plane. So this could be useful if, for example, you're checking the flatness of something like floor flatness or whatever, or maybe you have something that has some kind of a elevation change, or maybe you're looking at the front of a building and the wall is shifting or something, but you want to check to see how much is it's shifting and where. And so this is a really simple way. Now this is using a relatively new feature in CloudCompare. It's just a second from the bottom on the right side here. So I'll be going through that. And we're going to do this a couple of times with two different scans. One will be in the vertical direction, and then one will be at the face of an old building. So let's get started on this. I'm using CloudCompare, the latest version. So this is going to be 2.13.1. And let's start with a little mound here. I'm just going to drag and drop a scan in here. And you can have a look. So this is actually a scan that was done with Recon 3D. So just this dirt mound, nothing that crazy. But you'll see that it's contained more or less by this border here, a concrete or stone border or something like that. So with this, what I'm going to do is I'm going to say, hey, where is my plane? Okay, what do I want to measure this to, or reference to? And I want to measure it in reference to, let's say, the edges here, because I just don't have a really good plane to put in place. So yeah, what I'll do is I'll be picking points, let's say, in the corners here, and the more points I pick, it will add to the plane. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to select this where it says Fort Mound. And over here on the bottom, it says perform normal distance measurements against a plane. Cool. I'm going to click on that. And you'll see I get this little window that pops up, and it wants me to start picking points. So when I move my mouse over here, you'll see that I've got this little crosshair. So it's important that I pick something which is planar. So, and this is basically the magic behind this whole thing, or the most important part, is that you need to find a good reference plane. If you don't have a good reference plane, then you're in trouble. You have to either make one, import one, or find a way to pick points, you know, that gives you a good reference. So for me, it's going to be these corners here. So I'm going to go one over here, and it calls that point zero. And you'll see now that it's populated with these coordinates. I'm going to pick this corner here. So just on the top, that's two. Now, as soon as I pick the next point, it's going to create a plane, and it's going to start giving me my deviation. But I'm just going to set this up so I know more or less where I'm going to be picking. So I'll pick a point about here. It'll create the plane, and then I'm going to come over and pick a point here just to add a fourth point, okay, to lock this thing in place. So let me do that. I'm going to click here. Okay, you see a whole bunch of things shifted, and I know that I've got a point over here as well. Click there, and now I've added another plane. Okay, so automatically here, it's added the color ramp, which you can see on the right side. And actually, I think I'm going to move my window here so you can see this freely. Now, here you have all the points, and if I go ahead and go measurement, you'll see that there's some things that we can do here, okay? So it's got signed measurement, okay? So it gives you positive and negative. It gives you unsigned. So this would be like an absolute measurement. So it's looking at this plane, both at points above and below the plane, okay? Which ones are blue and so forth, right? And then it says show normal vector. So it's saying, hey, which way is the plane pointing or whatever, which is kind of cool. Now, if I click on measurement, let's see what happens. If I go click and I go click and I click and I'm just taking all these points here like that, you'll see that it's giving me the distance from the plane, and I can save this. So if I hit save and I go to my desktop or whatever, you'll see that I can just save it as a CSV file, which is kind of cool. Now, I won't do that. I think you know how to do that part, and you can open it up in another program, but very, very useful here. Now, if I close this, I still have the ramp with the measurements here, and everything is saved over here in the database tree. Okay, so that's kind of useful. Also, if I click on the point cloud here, and it has the little point cloud symbol, click on it, and I scroll down here, you have basically your histogram or your color ramp, whatever you want to call it over here. And you can modify this. So if I take the little triangle and I start moving this down, you'll see on my screen, okay, there's more points that are being included as red. And if I go on the left side here and I do the same, there's more points which are being included as blue. So you can change how this is displayed. displayed. Although the points right now will remain the same. So if I click on a specific point, I will get the information for how far it is from that plane. So a quick way to do that, by the way, if I wanted to create, like these are little measurements, but if I wanted something to display, is I could hold down the shift key and just click any point. So if I click at a point on the top here, you'll see that it gives me this little label and it saves this label over here. If I click on one that's low, click on that. Okay. It'll give me more labels that are down here and it gives me, hey, this point here is 0.097. So that's almost 10 centimeters from the plane. This one here is 1.705 meters from the plane. So I get a lot of information. Now this histogram here, if I click on the histogram, now you have to have the point cloud selected and then there's a little histogram up here. If I click on that, this gives me the distribution of the points here. Okay, so I've got all this stuff and you'll see that, you know, I've got a whole bunch of points that are over here. And if you click and drag on this window, you can see if I move over here to about, that's about 30, 35, so about 0.35 centimeters. Okay, it says that about 64.84% of the points fall below the 65% range. So at 35 centimeters. So this will change depending on where the plane is located, obviously. And right now we're using points that are above and below. And maybe I don't want to include what is below. And for that, we need to segment the point cloud here. So let's do this again. And I'm going to segment the point cloud. And this is going to be important because on the next thing that I'm going to show you, we're not going to be doing something in the vertical. We're going to be doing something in the horizontal plane, on the sort of side to side, like the front face of a building. And I need to be able to cut out all the things that I don't need. So I want to show it to you here as well. Okay, let's do this. I don't need all this stuff right now. So if I go into this plane, I can delete it. I have all these labels and stuff. I don't need these either. So I'm just going to start back with what I had before and I'm going to go to the RGB. So if you click on Fort Mound, you go to colors. It was showing the scalar field, which was the colors that it created, but I'm just going to go back to red, green, and blue. And this is back where I started. So for me to start cropping or cutting and things like that, there's different ways I can do it. Normally I would do it with the segmentation tool, but I could also use the cross-section tool. So with the scan selected here, I'm just going to go to the cross-section tool. And you'll see that I get all these arrows and circles and such that are selected. So what I want to do is I want to isolate everything which is just along the border here of the this mound over here. So go from the bottom, I'm going to click on the arrow and I'm going to move it up, 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 up. And you'll see that I'm starting to cut some things off, right? Now, this may not be perfectly level. So what I need to do is I need to rotate this a little bit and minimize what I have underneath the top. So I'm going to lift this up a tiny bit more like that. You see that I'm just getting the tops here. And let's see if I have the same on this side. Yeah, that's pretty good. Maybe I need to change that just a little bit. So I'm going to be a little bit, there we go. I'm going to be a little bit pickier. If I just click on the edges, maybe I got to drop this down a tiny bit like that. And I think that's good enough. So what I'm going to do here is there's a button right here. And if I click on this, it'll take what is visible here and it's going to save it as its own entity. Okay. Something separate. So it's basically a copy and just the part that I need. So if I do that, I'm going to copy that. You'll see that it actually put down this little section over here. So let me close this off. And I'm going to shut off the original point cloud and go to just what I exported right now. And I'm just going to perform the exact same thing that I did before with this selected. I'm going to go down to this normal distance measurement and I just need to select my points again. So I'm going to start with the hard ones here, which is this one, maybe this one. And then I'm going to select this one and then I'm going to select this one right there. Oh, here we go. Try it again. Move it a bit. There we go. So I got the points. Now you'll notice that the histogram here is a lot different. Okay. So let me close this and let me bring up the histogram with this section here. There you go. You'll notice that this is a lot different because I've chosen a similar plane, but the points that I'm asking it to include have been removed. So all that other noise that was there is not there. So now if I go back to the, 35 centimeter mark before we had about, 65% of the points. Now we only have about 37.6% of the points that are there. Okay. So again, if you want to just take a lot of some quick measurements, you can always bring up this window again and you can go to the measurements tabs and start clicking and exporting those measurements. If you just want it on screen, you can hold down the shift key and just click on a point. Point, you know, click on different things, and basically you get these measurements that are available to you. So you can see here, this point is about 1.6 meters up. This one is about 1.2, and down low, it's about, you know, 0.16 meters down here. Okay, so that's one example here that we're doing, but what I'm going to do now is I'm going to close this out and I'm going to bring in a new scan here. So I'm just going to get rid of all of this. Okay, good. Let's try it again. I'm going to bring in a building here. Okay, so this is a scan that I did on vacation with Recon 3D, and I want to look at the front face of this building, and I have all these, you know, damaged sections and things that are falling apart or whatever. So I need to establish a plane on the front face here. So I think what I'm going to do is I'll pick a point somewhere up here. I'll pick a point somewhere down here. And something that doesn't look as damaged. So maybe something over here, or actually this part here still has the paint and some, you know, it looks like it's part of the original surface. So maybe I'll pick a point over here and call that a plane. So we'll see how that goes. But I do need to isolate just the face of this here, because if I do the measurement this way, it's going to capture all this stuff back here and in front and stuff like that. I don't want that. So I'm going to do what I did before, which is select the point cloud. And I'm going to click on the cross-section tool. And you'll see here, it's not oriented in the same way. So in order to change that, I can just use this vertical circle to kind of get it square a little bit, more or less. And I can just tweak this off. So I'm going to go get rid of the back. I'll get rid of the front like this. I do need to make a little bit more of a tweak, but I can do that in a second. I'm going to cut this off. I'm going to cut this off. That looks like the edge of the building. And obviously, it's not square. So let me rotate this around a bit and see what I get. So I've cut off probably a bit too much, but I'm squaring it up. Let me back up here a bit. No, the back is okay. It's the front that is the problem. So let me go back this way. There we go. So I've got just this, but I think I need a bit more. Let me go back. Yeah, so right about there. And let me see if I can get rid of the back a tiny bit more without infringing on the front. So you see, I'm starting to get rid of some of the points at the bottom here. So let me leave it like, that's about as much as I can take off. And I think I'll just drop down a bit. I don't want that stuff up there. And I can go a little bit higher there. Okay, I think that's good enough. That's what I'll use. I'm gonna save this out as its own point cloud. There we go, I'm gonna close this out. Perfect. So I don't need this original anymore. I'm going to shut that off by just hitting the checkbox here. Select this. So this is what I'm going to work on. Yep. Good enough. So again, just go back to the tool down here. So normal distance measurement against the plane. And now I need to select a plane. And for this one, maybe I'll just click on three points. So I'll click one up here. I'll click one over here. And then I'll click one on this little patch here like that. Okay, there we go. So now you are seeing that I've got, let me close that out. Okay, I've got my plane that's been established and it's checking everything against here. So I'm going to shut off the plane just from a visibility standpoint. It just makes it a little bit easier. And you can see like some of the areas that are damaged more here, more or less. And I can exaggerate these two. So I need to go back and do what I did before. Click on the point cloud, scroll down in the properties. And if I take the little triangle on the high end, this will adjust the reds. Okay, the red, more things will start to turn red. So I can see where there's like really a lot of damage here and it pops out right away. Again, if you want to click on a shift click on any point, here, 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 you'll get all of the distances here. Now we're talking about, you know, this is like 3 millimeters. This is like, you know, 8. This is 1.7 centimeters. So we're starting to get the distance to the plane of all of these points. So it's a very, very useful tool. You can also go back with the point cloud selected, click on the this normal measurement tool again. And again, we've got this measurement tab and we can change this up. So if we want measurements or distances, we can do a bunch of different things here. Okay, I think I'm going to leave it at that. Just a quick tool here that makes it really easy to check flatness, to check the level or the height or distance away from a plane, and just giving you some insight into a tool that maybe you can use in the future. So hopefully we'll see you again soon. Have a good day. Bye-bye.